Now I invite Dr. Mani to give his talk on surgical challenges in mentally ill patients.
Good evening, doctors. I won't take much of your time. I recently lost a patient who was suffering from schizophrenia for more than 20 years. He was treated by various psychiatrists, and one of his daughter was employed in public health center. That's how that patient came to me from another psychiatrist. And now, when I was a student doing house agency in way back in 1978 in Stanley Medical College, I had a when was the admission day in the surgical unit. The duty assistant surgeon saw a case and then he said it's a perforated peptic ulcer. In those days, only modality was plain X-ray abdomen. There's gas and with the diaphragm. So take him to the theater and prepare him for surgery, and they did an emergency laparotomy and the perforation closure was done. Before the duty assistant surgeon, he left the hospital. The next day, he called Maniwada rounds poi paakalam, post-operative ward. When we went and saw the patient, he removed all the sutures, he opened the abdomen and he was examining all the intestine on the bed. He was just taking all the intestine, he was examining his intestine by himself. The surgeon got really shocked to see a patient on the second day, seeing his abdomen has been opened like a hernia. Now this patient was basically the history was the patient was a schizophrenic and the history was not taken properly in those days and it was done in an emergency situation. Now similar situation has happened and coincidentally his name is also Mani and he was a politician and he was performing reasonably well with the medication for more than 20 years. He's a paranoid schizophrenic and he's also a diabetic patient. On a regular medication, he was admitted in PHC for acute retention of urine. Now, the usual teaching is all the long-standing psychiatric medicines and diabetic medicines are known to cause retention of urine. So I referred the patient to urologist. The investigation and the results were done and the doctor said we'll take him for immediately for assessment of cystoscopy. And a cystoscopy was done, an ultrasound abdomen was done, and he had a prostatic enlargement, so the doctor said put him in a Foley's catheter. Now during this period the patient was very disturbed because he was telling me you'll never allow the door to be opened. It says doctor avangala enna paakranga enna kolapana poranga polukku aalachi adikka poranga they say the door close for you. Now, this was the situation. The patient was taken to the for a diagnostic cystoscopy and then he was put on an catheter and next day he was taken for a surgery. Then they did a transurethral resection of the prostate and then he was sent to the ward. Immediately after sending him to the ward, he stood on the from the cot and then he pulled his tubes. There was a massive hemorrhage and then he was again immediately rushed to the theater. The hemorrhage has to be controlled. Lot of blood units were given and there was a very stormy post-operative period. And then after 4-5 days, reasonably he settled down in his medical condition. The relative said that he was disturbed in the hospital situation, so kindly discharge him. So we discharged him at request and the patient went home. Still he was disturbed. Again he had a bleed and then he came to the hospital. Again he was taken to the theater. Now the lessons learned, during the post-operative period he was bleeding so heavily and then he went into severe anemia. A renal shutdown. After a period of 1 month, the patient died. And what I want to tell you is the lessons learned from this patient was proper planning and preparation of the patient for surgical procedure would have minimized the complications. I remember well about 15 years back in Chowdhupa's clinic, he was operating a psychiatric patient. Suddenly on the table he became very violent. So he sent me an emergency call. I went into the theater, I sedated him and the surgery was finished. Now this is very important and the important take home message from this loss of this patient is that detailed history of past and present mental illness has to be elicited in all patients who are undergoing surgical procedures. Most of the time we ask about the medical history, sometimes the psychiatric history is overlooked and the patient do not come out with it unless you ask a leading question whether you are on any antipsychotics or antidepressants. History of alcohol and drug abuse have to be taken because many of the times heroin addicts may come to you with an acute abdomen during the withdrawal stage, what we call as cold turk. which may be mistaken as an appendicitis, and you may open the abdomen, then the post-operative period will be very strong. In emergency close coordination, as in this case, we worked together, but still the patient was so restless, we lost the patients. Special precautions in elderly and dementing patients. Many of the orthopedic surgeons, if they are any, always operate on 90-year-old patient who's got a dementia or a mild cognitive impairment. On the third day or fourth day of a knee replacement or a hip replacement, they go into a very severe confusional state, and it's very difficult to manage such elderly patients. Now, psychological testing has to be done for cosmetic surgery. One of my plastic surgeons has told in US, one of the patients asked for a corrective rhinoplasty, like Sridevi who did a nose workup for cosmetic reasons. Now, he did a pre-evaluation of the patient's psychological profile. I was told that the patient shot him dead. The plastic surgeon was shot dead by the patient, saying that his correction is not good and he made his face ugly. So you have to be very careful. Even in the case of bariatric surgery, which is now picking up very well for obesity, you have to do a pre-operative counseling. Thank you.
Only one thing I want to say is it's not enough if you take the history from the patient alone, because most of the time some of the patients, they don't want to reveal, especially women. Number two, some of them, they think it's very, very small and need not reveal. So what we have to do, we have to get the relatives also, we have to ask their side. And if they still refuse, what we have to do, we have to ask them what drugs you have been taking so far. And sometimes when we get the drugs, we know that they have been taking some antidepressant drugs. Because I was in, as I already told you, I was in trouble in some of the patients post-operatively.
Yeah.
So this is very important.
So whenever they ask, the surgeon may ask you to stop the psychiatric drugs, you have to be very careful. If it is an antipsychotic drug, then the patient may have an acute withdrawal. Antipsychotics cause extrapyramidal symptoms or a rebound vomiting. So you have to overcome that with the Finergon injections, or by needle you have to substitute this injection during the surgical procedures. It's very, very important, because suddenly if you stop the antipsychotics, the patient will have an extrapyramidal reaction like this, all his limbs will go twisted. So you have to be very careful.
Thank you very much, sir. It was very informative, especially for me, because I get to do emergency surgeries. And sometimes I have stopped antipsychotics suddenly, not knowing what to do. Of course, we have always restarted these drugs on the second post-operative day.